So this is it. The project is entitled Zooarchaeology and Mobility in the Western Mediterranean, has on the production from the Late Bronze Age to Late Antiquity, and you have here the team members. We are working in close collaboration on the project. Is developed at FESIC, it's the National Research Center here, and with the University of Oxford, and then we are doing the isotopes with Georgians in Montpellier. The basic premise that we have is that fauna remains reflect animal husbandry, production, which in turn is shaped by human decisions, like the selection of species, the animal size, the age of the slaughter, and this is reflecting economic and social practices. And now, personal practice in isotopic chemistry and ancient DNA text that we can explore animal mobility.
And this is what we are doing.
What we want to know is the relationship between animal mobility and animal husbandry, how animal mobility changes animal husbandry. And we are taking this chronology, and you'll see why.
From the first millennium BC to the 8th century AD.
So we have a multi-proxy perspective. We are combining archaeology, of course, to have the context, and zooarchaeology to have animal husbandry. And then isotopic chemistry and ancient DNA to explore mobility and see how these three things interact with each other. This is the structure of the project. We are creating a zooarchaeological and archaeological database which we can use with a GIS system. Then a package devoted to the isotopic chemistry on mobility, which is strontium, oxygen, then ancient DNA, and then at the end, we will combine the three lines together to see what can we say about the consequences of territoriality for mobility and for economy in this time period.
And why this territoriality? Why is
this in our minds? Because, well, you probably know this is very general. Of course, some regional differences exist. But broadly, from the late Bronze Age to late antiquity, there's an increase and a decrease of the level of economic integration and also social complexity. So in the late Bronze Age, we see semicircular huts made of baseball materials, usually located in the valleys, then Iron Age, fortified sites, Roman period, near Central Manhattan, and then these changes in late antiquity when there's a reduction in the level of economic integration. And we wanted to know how these changes shape animal husbandry. So we are working at different levels. We are working for some sites at the level of the site, then regional perspective, and then macro regional to see how different regions compare to others. We are only taking waste deposits, so non-ritual assemblages, because this could be for other reasons. We are taking only the assemblages that have a certain number of remains for the domestic triad that have good preservation and good dating. So we are discarding quite a number of assemblages, but we want to guarantee that the data we have are relevant
and reliable.
I'm not going to present the first zoom, it would be too much. So I will move to the second, the regional scale. For this region, northeastern Iberian Peninsula, presently Catalonia, we are subdividing the regions as well, according to, in this case, classical sources. So here we have different entities. And for the presentation, this is the column code, so cattle are in blue, pigs are in red, and sheep and goats are in green. And we have the different periods for the Occidental Plain, the Central Coast, and then the North Coast.
Overall, what you can see here
is that in the Iron Age, so this starts in the late Bronze Age, up to Roman times, and here is antiquity, okay? In the Iron Age, there's a kind of a bit of uniformization between different regions. The North Coast is a bit different. And overall, the growth tendency that we can see is that there is a reduction in the frequencies of cattle through time from the late Bronze Age to Iron Age, and then an increase in Roman times and a decrease in late antiquity.
And this is happening more or less in three areas, although with differences between them, of course. How this compares with other regions?
The first time we saw this was very shocking, because we found out that, okay, Languedoc and Catalonia, they are very close. The tendency is more or less the same. Okay. You could expect that it's similar environment, similar settlement patterns. But you can see that there is this reduction from the Roman times to the Iron Age and increasing over time. This was much more surprising, because in England, if you have been in England and you have been here, it's quite different all the year round, but the tendency is still the same. So a decrease from the Roman times to the Iron Age, then an increase in over time. Also in Tunisia, here in over time, the cattle still dropped, and here in Etruria, Central Italy, the tendency happens before. So there's a reduction during the Bronze Age, but then as soon as the Etruscan civilization starts, we find more cattle. And then there's the Roman phenomenon, they are crazy about pigs, and this is a different story. It was also quite surprising to see that not only cattle frequencies, but also the size of the animals was changing quite in a similar way. So here you have the census from Languedoc. You have one data for the Neolithic, but then you can see some reduction in size in the Iron Age and an increase in Roman times. Same thing here in Catalonia. Same thing in England. Same thing in Tunisia. And in North Central Italy, again, it happens a bit before. So from the Neolithic to the Bronze Age, and then, as soon as the Etruscans appear, there's fermentation in size. And this is happening in different ecosystem and cultures. This is happening in landscapes that look quite different. So we have similar processes, not directly linked to ecology. Because again, this is happening at slightly different times. So, this is the mobility part. Why mobility is important? Why we are caring about it? Well, because mobility is very important in animal husbandry to overcome the shortage of fodder, especially in the Mediterranean area, because then you can increase the carrying capacity. You can produce more and your animals will be better. But in order to move, you need to be able to move. That means you need to be able to lead your animals through the landscape. And either you have the right of way, either in a structured or non-structured way. This can happen in two ways. If the demographic density is very low, you can bring your animals because nobody is going to prevent it. There's not enough people. But if the landscape is completely occupied, then we need to reach agreements with other people. And in general, there's a political entity that allows and usually protects the movement. Think about the emperor in Rome, or the medieval kings, or the medieval monasteries. They are controlling and guaranteeing that the movements of livestock can be done. Okay, so we are using strontium isotopes. This is more or less the cycle. The basic principle is that strontium is dependent on the underlying bedrock, so we can trace where the animals were grazing. And then we can see what happens. These are the strontium ratios. For England, we analyzed four sites, dated from different periods, from the Neolithic to the late Roman times. This band here, it's because all of them are taken in southern England, quite close to two different geological layers, we consider that both the blue and the green signatures were the local ones. Okay, so this band here is indicating the range for this area of Northern Green. Okay? Anything that goes outside this band comes from both places. The ones that fall into this band are compatible with these two ranges. Okay? You can see that from the Neolithic to the Iron Age, there's quite a dramatic reduction in the variability of the strontium variability of cattle analyzed. And this is not dependent on the sample size. We tested it. So it's significant. Then in Roman times, we do find much more variability.
And this is correlating, if you remember, well, I don't advance the conclusion.
Same thing is happening here in Languedoc. We did a pilot study on the 7 teeth. But again, 7 teeth from the Iron Age fall into the local signature. 3 of the Roman times, only 1 fall in the local signature, and 2 were coming from somewhere else. When we analyzed different taxa, we realized that different species can have different mobility patterns. This was quite a surprise as well. At the beginning, sheep are moving much less than cattle in the same size and the same chronology.
So, why is this?
Especially taking into account that sheep make up, this is one side, but it's generalized to many of the sites of this region. Sheep make, in general, up to the 80% of the fauna remains. It's normal. We have a range between 60 and 80 sheep and goats, and cattle is only between 5 and 12, 15, more or less 3% of the remains. Why are cattle moving more than sheep? Well, explanation can be that they have different rhythms of life. If you have a cow, a cattle, you are going to keep it for 6, 7, 10 years, as long as they can work, so their life is much longer, whereas sheep and goats are the meat providers. So you kill them much earlier in time. These are the mortality profiles. So from 0 to 10 years, you can see that cattle live much longer than sheep, that are the meat providers, okay? So if you want a good cattle to work, you're going to make the investment to look for it further away. Whereas sheep and goats, there are a lot, you take them from the vicinity, the local area, and that's it.
So it makes sense. So what can we see from this thing? Well, first we have a progressive diminution in the frequency of cattle and animal size in this time period. There's an increase in Roman times, decrease in late antiquity. So there's a correlation with the level of economic integration. It also seems that only in the Iron Age, despite there's a lot of trade in the Mediterranean, only certain products are circulating, not livestock, or not in very general extent. Another thing is that different territories with different ecologies and cultures have similar processes. Cattle and sheep have different mobility patterns, so and it responds to adapt to production. And the results suggest that mobility depends on the degree of economic integration and political decisions.
And this is shaping animal husbandry. That's why we have less cattle or more cattle, bigger animals, smaller animals.
So if you think about it, if the movement is difficult, if you have many different political entities, territorialized, fortified, protecting the territory, if you want to go to one place, you need to reach an agreement with many different people. And it's going to be difficult. If only one says no, you can't. So easily, you can have a decrease of the DNA pool and an increase of the dietary stress. So that could lead to overgrazing, and this has a direct impact on size and the amount of cattle that you can sustain. So you have a combination of inbreeding and increase of dietary stress. Compared to that, if the movement is easy, either because there are no boundaries or the boundary is very large, which would be in Roman times, then if movement is easy, you can increase easily the DNA pool by trade, by exchange, and this increases the dietary stress because in summer you can move to a better place.
So you can have more and bigger cattle.
And this is so apparent in the archaeological record. We have here Bronze Age cattle in Catalonia, Iron Age, Late Iron Age, Roman, also Roman, Late Antiquity, present day cattle. It's so perceptible, it's striking, really, how the same bone changes in size and shape for time. So thank you for your attention.